Okay, now that you've chosen the place in which you will build your facility, there's something else we have to look at, and that's called facility layout. How are we going to lay out our facility? Again, based on the amount of capacity, but the important thing here is what product or products are we producing? And that's going to determine our facility layout. A product-oriented layout is a layout in which you're producing the same or similar products in high volume or high demand. Now, this is also called a sequential layout. There aren't a lot of product variations when it comes to a product-oriented layout, which is why it's called product or sequential. You're producing almost the exact same thing over and over and over again. So the layout fits the dominant flow of that particular product. Hence, product layout, or you're producing in a consistent sequence, a sequential layout. Now, that's when you have the same or similar products being produced. So when it comes to Apple, the iPhone, probably product-oriented layout because you're producing slight variations of the exact same product, maybe just different sizes and different features. Now, the process-oriented layout in which you're producing many different products on the same equipment, typically at a lower volume of several individual products. Now, this is also called a functional layout. If you're have a hospital, you probably have a functional layout because the hospital operates in different aspects, right? You have the emergency wing, you have labor and delivery, and then you may have severe patients, whatever the case may be. But because of that, it's not sequential or product oriented, is process oriented because of the nature of health work that goes into healthcare. And this is why you're building your facility more so for a process and not a specific product. Easy to remember, a product oriented layout or sequential layout, you build in a sequence in which you're producing the same or a very similar product at high demand over and over and over again. And if you're not doing that and you're producing several different products, you want to use a process-oriented layout. So it's really based on the process in which you're doing things. Remember, this is also called a functional layout. Another layout you can have is what we called a fixed position layout. And this is just a layout where you're doing something that you just need huge space, right? Or you're building a large item. Let's say the airplanes and things that we fly in, they're being manufactured somewhere, right? So a fixed position layout is going to be beneficial because of the size of the product that you're producing. So in some instances, just a very large building with a fixed position can be necessary to produce your product. Key takeaways. When choosing your facility layout, think about what you're producing. If it's just one product, the same thing, or very similar products, you want to choose a product-oriented layout or a sequential layout. And if you're producing different items, lower volume, but a variety of items, then you want to think about the process in which you produce those items, a process-oriented layout, also called a functional layout.